Carol Burnett in Once Upon a Mattress, brought to you by Lipton Tea. We're delighted to have you with us for another Lipton Tea special program, starring Miss Carol Burnett.
The fanciful tale about the princess who was so sensitive that she felt a pea under 20 mattresses. Well, I can tell you the true story of the princess and the pea for the very good reason that I was there serving as minstrel at the court where it all took place. The princess in the true story was not the only girl put to the test to prove her royalty. There were many others, all brought in from neighboring kingdoms and given impossible tests thought up by the queen and her confidant, the wizard. This was princess number 12.
Would you repeat that last question, please?
What was the middle name of the daughter-in-law of the second cousin once removed of the blacksmith who forged the sword Excalibur? You have 10 seconds.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. But yours didn't tell us quite enough.
The thoughtful queen always gave a consolation prize.
Goodbye! Good luck and get out. Oh. You see, sweetheart, she wasn't a real princess.
Poor Prince Dauntless. I fear in this drama he rarely says more than...
Yes, Mama.
The court was disturbed when the prospect was nixed, but the ladies were positive.
Test was fixed.
Cheer up, ladies. I have a new trick. Watch closely. I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment, no folds, creases, or concealed pockets.
We know your tricks. That test wasn't fair.
It's the law that isn't fair.
The queen had passed a law which said...
Throughout the land, no one may wed till Dauntless shares his marriage bed.
This ridiculous law I had boldly defied and had secretly made Lady Larkin my bride. I told one good friend of my marriage, of course. His reaction was...
Why don't you get a divorce?
The jester loved her, too. He pours out his heart to his good friend, the king, who responds with a look, for he can't say a thing. His majesty was mute. As for her majesty, the queen herself will now advance, and we shall see who wears the royal pants.
Come along, sweetheart. Don't dawdle. Pick up your feet, precious.
Angel,
don't squint. How many times have I told you not to look at the sun?
Ow! Oh!
Maximus! If I've told you once, I've told you 100,000 times. I will not have you playing these foolish games and running around in the halls. It simply is not dignified. We are the rulers of this kingdom, and if we don't set a proper example for the rest of the court, I'd like to know who will. I mean, what is the point of being a ruler if one is not going to behave as a ruler should?
Mama?
Yes, pussycat.
Mama? When am I going to get my princess?
Dauntless, I don't want to discuss that now. It's time for your cocoa.
But, Mama, sometimes I get the funniest feeling that you don't want me to get married.
Don't want you to get married? Dauntless, don't you trust me?
Oh, of course not.
Well, how can you say such a thing? I want you to get married. How many times have I said to you, I want you to get married? Why, only this morning I was saying to your father, I said, Sextimus, I want that boy to get married. It simply is not normal for a boy his age to stay single. And after all, he's the prince, I said, don't forget that. He's next in line to the throne. I mean, we may not be the oldest people in the kingdom, but on the other hand, we are not going to live forever. And I just know that I'd feel much better, much easier and more relaxed in my mind if that boy were married and settled and set. And that is absolutely verbatim exactly what I said to your father this morning. Of course, he didn't say anything. He never does. Marvin, you know him as well as I do. I don't have to tell you how impossible he is. Well, that's my cross of pain. And I don't want you to worry your head one little bit about the fact that your father and I don't get along and never have. If he makes me miserable and makes me suffer, well, I'll just have to put up with it. And I will not allow it to affect my child's attitude toward him or me. He may be a mean, stupid, dreadful, selfish, rotten man, but he is your father. And I want you to respect him. Oh, there is only one person who really cares about you and really worries about your health and your happiness and your future. And that's what I'm talking about right now, your future. You are a prince. And you must marry someone suitable, someone who's good enough and fine enough and smart enough for my good, nice, sweet, beautiful baby boy. And she must be a princess. I mean a real princess. That's one thing I absolutely insist upon. She has to be a real, genuine, bona fide princess, just as I was. Oh, that's what you really want, isn't it, darling? Someone like me. Of course you do. Oh, if I were only 20 years younger. This. You may roam the whole world over, but you'll never find another, be it ever so humble. There's no place like your mother.
Now. For many weeks, the court had to listen to this monologue. As winter turned into spring, the lords and ladies of the court all but gave up hope that a true princess of the royal blood would ever be found for Dauntless. And then, one sunny morning in mid-April, when the crocuses were just beginning to dot the meadows, the lookout in the North Round Tower thought he saw a figure in the distance approaching on foot.
What is it? It's a girl, or something.
And the word was spread. Now let's see, how did that part go in the old story? On a stormy night to the castle door came the lass the prince had been waiting for. That, of course, is utterly untrue. It didn't storm that night at all. In fact, it wasn't even night, and the princess only looked as if she'd come in from a storm.
With me, can't you see? timid and horribly. Though a lady may be dripping with glamour, as often as not, she will stumble and stammer when suddenly confronted with romance. And she's likely to fall on her face when she's finally face to face with a pair of pants. Quite often the lady's not as hard to please as she seems. Quite often she'll settle for something less than the man of her dreams.
Princess of the royal blood. Yes. And am I actually to understand that you have the nerve and the gall and the presumption to apply for my son's hand in marriage?
Mama, may I say something?
No. Do you imagine for one moment that I would even find you suitable for any son of mine, huh? Well, you are laboring under a very unfortunate misapprehension, my dear. No son of mine is ever going to marry any moat swimmer. Not while I have a breath left in my body. And I haven't been well. Not well at all. I get these shooting pains all in through here. And don't try and tell me it's the vapors. I know what the vapors are. I've had the vapors.
Are you new here?
Yes.
Watch closely. I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment.
No. It's a nut house. Oh, please. Oh, please. Please.
No, wait.
You're the one, I guess, huh?
Sure. I'm Prince Dauntless, the drab.
Glad to have met you.
Oh, no, please don't go. I like you. Everybody does.
Ha!
Almost everybody.
Dauntless, I'd like to stay here, but I wouldn't want to come between you and your mother.
Oh, but I really like you. I really like her, Mama. Can I marry her? Can I?
Oh, marry her? Of course not. When you marry, if you marry, you'll marry a real princess.
I am a real princess.
I'm sure she's a princess.
She must be a princess.
Thanks, girl.
At least the test, Your Majesty.
Oh, at least a test, not for me, Mama, please.
Oh, all right, we'll test her.
Hooray!
The Wizard and I will put on our thinking caps and make up a nice, fair test, just as we always do. And she'll fail just like all the others, fair and square.
Test? What? What test?
The royalty test.
Oh, every princess suing for my hand must pass a test to prove she's a real princess.
What kind of test?
It's always highly secret.
Oh. Well, we'll worry about that later. Right now, I'd better get out of these wet clothes.
May I show you part of the castle on the way to your room?
Sure.
nice.
You're nicer.
You're good looking, too.
You're better looking and nicer, too.
Well, you're a better swimmer.
Princesses, 12 tests, 12 failures. The ladies of the court had little hope that princess number 13 would be any different. Unlucky ladies.
Yes, a safe spinster's life for them.
Why, you don't miss it, do you?
Oh, heavens, no. But I do worry about what will happen to us if the Queen finds out that we broke the law and are secretly married.
She won't find out.
I'm not so sure. Do you remember the royal joust on Whitsunday last?
Certainly.
And do you remember the picnic we all had later on the greensward with the lovely cold pheasant?
Yes, of course.
And you and I wandered away from the others to climb the hill and watch the sun go down.
Yes.
And then we watched the sun go down.
Yes.
Well, I'm going to have a baby.
Well, that's marvelous.
So you see, she's going to find out quite soon.
Well, that's very simple. We'll go away.
But the Queen would never allow that, and the palace is heavily guarded.
That's a detail.
Well, even if we could escape, where could we go?
Over the wall. Over the hills and down to the sea, where a ship will be waiting.
And then?
Normandy. So Normandy is where we'll go. I can show you a beach where the peach blossom blows. And I know how to reach a man who knows, a man who knows a cozy inn. A friendly place with rows of windows facing the sea. This time of year, the air I hear is rare and clear and warm in Normandy. I know a meadow covered with mustard flowers, golden as the sun, where a wondrous thing can happen when an April day is done. Moment after the twilight, when the sky is suddenly green, and the world stands hushed and waiting for the first white stars to convene. When you've seen that emerald sky, you'll know the reason why. There's not another place for us to be. Don't be afraid, my darling. Sigh no more.
Go ahead.
don't know why I try to help you when you won't even help yourself. Minstrel, I give your marriage 1 week, and after that...
What is it, sire? You want me to sing a song for you? What kind of song? A funny song? About what? The Queen? Again? I have the feeling that you don't care for the Queen. Oh, the Queen is quite often in bed, racked with pain from her heel to her head. For such illness, I'm sure there is only one cure: to get up and go out and drop dead. If Her Majesty takes my advice, she will cheer up the court. And she'll doubly delight every lady and knight if she does it upright and drops dead twice.
Out.
Your Majesty.
You are banished from my court and from this kingdom forever. I'll see you never work again.
Now, Your Majesty, please.
Out of the castle by sunset.
But...
Out, out, out! I never liked him anyway. He wouldn't play in my key. Now, I am in no mood to spend hours racking my brains over a test for that girl when I've got aches here and here and a strange nagging pain in my jaw. How would you describe her?
Crude.
Oh, well then, we'll test her for sensitivity. Oh, yes, she'll have her test. Oh, the worst of it is that foolish boy actually seems to like the girl. So we must think of a test that looks fair, and sounds fair, and seems fair, and isn't fair. But what?
Table manners?
Oh, that's not good enough. Sensitivity. Sensitivity, sensitivity, I'm just loaded with that. In this one word is the epitome of the aristocrat. Sensitive soul and sensitive stomach, sensitive hands and feet. This is the blessing, also the curse of being the true elite. Common people don't know what exquisite agony is. By gentle people like me.
Aww.
Get your hands off me. Think of a tricky test. Well, I'm wretched moat swimming princess.
Madam, may I suggest? Maybe we ought to.
Don't take all night. I'm not well. I need my rest. Not that I ever sleep on that lumpy mattress. He jabbed my back. Sensitivity, bane of royalty, that bed's a torture rack. But my nerves are so jumpy. I am sure I could feel any lump even if it were under the mattress and small as a pea. That's the answer, under the mattress. We'll test her tonight. One tiny pea beneath one thick downy mattress gets up your fright. Any genuine princess would feel it. If she doesn't, she's true. And order one mattress. No, make it two.
Why not five?
10, I think, would be plenty. Better still, make it 20. And to play it safe in the event, even that's not enough to ensure that she sleeps. We'll give her a soothing sedative, won't we? You can whip up a drink. Something stunning. Just devilish. I love the way you think. She's insensitive, so insensitive, she'll fall asleep, no doubt. My, but you're clever, brilliant, a genius. You are divine. Get up.
Was beside himself. By now it was clear to everyone that he had lost his heart. As for the princess, she was doing her best to make the adjustment to dry land.
Well, it certainly feels good to get into something dry. This
This old dress is just soaked.
Your Highness, excuse me, but the King has asked to meet the young lady.
Why? He's never asked before.
He heard she swam the moat.
Is your father anything like your mother? Because if he is...
Oh, no, my papa is silent.
Oh, I'd love to meet him.
Papa, this is Princess Winifred.
Your Highness, the King welcomes you.
Oh.
Oh, my father never touches his crown to his heart unless he really means it.
The King is mute, or he would speak for himself. He is still under a curse cast by a witch long ago, before Prince Dauntless was born. The curse says...
King Sextimus will never talk until the mouse devours the hawk.
Until the mouse devours the hawk. Well, can't you get a big mouse and a little hawk?
We tried that once. The mouse got scared and ran away, and the hawk bit Daddy.
Well, don't you worry. You just let me get this test under my belt and we'll figure out something. Well, it certainly has been a pleasure meeting His Majesty. A short while ago, I had the pleasure of meeting Her Majesty.
Your Majesty, don't you think it's time to speak to Prince Dauntless about, you know...
About what?
Your father thinks that since you're old enough to get married, you and he ought to have a little talk, you know, man to man. The King says, wait till later. He says that there are a few facts he wants to look up first.
I certainly do like almost both your parents, Dauntless.
Well, we want you to be happy here and feel right at home.
Where is home?
What kingdom are you from?
Oh, well, if you go due north from here...
You come to the mountains.
Then you're from the mountains.
You're a mountain blossom.
No, you have to cross over the mountains.
If you cross over the mountains, you come to the grasslands. You're a field flower.
No, you go through the grasslands.
You go through the grasslands, you come to the great marsh. The great marsh? But there's nothing out there except frogs and tadpoles and gook. You're a...
mud bud.
there's anything you need, be sure to call on us.
Thanks, girl. Dauntless, I have to change now.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
No, Dauntless, it's bad luck to see too much of the bride before the wedding. It needs something.
Did you say your name was?
Princess.
Well, whatever it is, we're giving an official ball tonight to honor you. Oh. To get her utterly exhausted so she'll sleep. Do you know any social dances? Do you know any tiring dances?
Oh, I know the swamp stomp. It goes da-da-da-da-da-da.
One, three.
There's a Saracen brawl.
Not tiring enough. I want something that will wear her out completely.
I'm afraid none of our people know that tricky little step.
We can do the Spanish panic. It's all the rage in Venice. Do you know it?
No.
Good. The wizard will show you everything. Now, throw yourself into it, my dear. Throw yourself into it. I want her dead to the world by midnight. Goodbye.
If your highness will permit me.
Sure.
Now, this is our right foot, and this is our left foot.
I've had that lesson already.
Then we may proceed more rapidly. Mm-hmm. Now, the basic step of the Spanish panic is flip your skirt open, close, right, right, right.
Right, right, right?
Right, right. Shall we try it?
Right.
Ready?
Right.
Flip your skirt open, close, right, right, wrong.
How about the swamp stop?
Spanish panic.
Right.
Ready.
Secret and all, but what sort of a test does your mama usually give?
Oh, well, with mama giving the test, it could be almost anything. For instance, one time, a little girl had to lift this weight. She couldn't. I can't even lift it. Oh, but you don't have to worry. You'll pass.
Do you want me to pass? I'll pass. I ever told you before. My full name is Winifred the Woebegone. But Winifred's too formal. You can call me by my nickname.
Winnie?
Fred.
Fred. What a beautiful name. So straight. So strong. So you. I like you, Fred. I like you.
You're just saying those words to be kind.
No, I mean it. I mean, I love you, Fred.
He is not of his medieval mind.
I'm perfectly sane and sound. I never felt better in my life. Everybody,
everybody, everybody, come
and meet my incipient wife.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. My reasons must be clear. When she shows you all how strong she is, you'll stand right up and cheer. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She drinks just like a lord. So come sing a merry drinking song and let the wine be poured.
Fill the boat to overflowing, raise the cup and high.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She sings just like a bird. You'll be left completely speechless when her gentle voice is heard.
Fill the boat till overflowing.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She wrestles like a Greek. You will clap your hands and wonder at her fabulous technique. Sing her praises till you're purple in the face.
Bravo, bravo, bravissimo, bravo, bravissimo.
Fill the boat till overflowing, raise the cup and high. With an F and an R and a D and a D and an F, R, E, D, Fred, yes. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She's musical to boot. She will set your feet a-tapping when she plays upon her lute.
Bravo, 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 brav
The queen kept everyone dancing until far into the night in an effort to exhaust the princess. When the ball was finally over, Winifred retired to her antechamber to get ready for bed, and the queen retired to the castle gallery to get the bed ready for Winifred. Everything was very quiet.
Quiet!
The queen insists on quiet. She saw the 20 mattresses, the softest and the best, and she threatened execution if we dare disturb the rest of her very special guest. She's ordered quiet, quiet. The queen insists on quiet. Quiet. The queen insists on quiet. Quiet. But she insists on quiet. Quiet. But she insists on quiet. Quiet. But she insists on quiet. Quiet.
This since I was a little boy. They're just like the ones Dad used to wear when he was court jester. Those were the days. I'm far from sentimental or romantic, and I like to think I'm strictly up to date. But at times the dancing gets a bit too frantic in these hectic days of 1428. So indulge me as I pause to raise my chalice to a quaint and charming dance they used to do. In the days when my dear father played the palace back in 1392. My dad was deaf, bonair, and quite as light as air. In his very soft shoes, how he could dip and glide and skip and slip and slide. In his very soft shoes, I used to stand and watch him every day. He was always smooth and cool. I used to love to hear the people say, he's a regular dancing fool. He barely touched the ground and never made a sound. But I've noticed in all his reviews that when he took his bow to the crowd in the crown, the crowd went crazy and the house came down. When Daddy wore his very soft
thank you.
Lady Larkin, come here. What are you doing with this person? Well, speak up.
You were running away,
is that it? You were running away. One of my girls running off with a musician.
I'm taking Lady Larkin with me.
Abducting a lady-in-waiting is stealing the personal property of the Queen, and that's treason. However, since you didn't actually get away with it, I'm only going to put you in the dungeon for one night only.
Your Majesty is very merciful.
And in the morning, your head will be chopped off.
Please,
Your Majesty, I remind you that you are still one of my ladies-in-waiting. Get below stairs where you belong and prepare, for bed. And the rest of you, listen closely. There is a little girl downstairs who is dog-tired. So I want quiet around here. Is that clear? I want quiet, and I am going to get quiet if I have to scream the palace down. Quiet!
And when he took his bow to the crown and the crown, the crowd went crazy, the house came down. When Daddy wore his very soft.
The lights in the castle flickered out one by one, but in Winifred's room, the lights still burned. The princess, with Dauntless's help, was doing her homework.
All right, just one more question in arithmetic.
All right.
How much is 3 times 17?
3 times 17. 3 times 7 is 21. Put down the 2, carry the 1. 3 times 1 is 3, plus the 1 you carried is 4. 24.
Oh, that isn't what the book says.
Well,
maybe you better add up 3 17s and see what you get.
Add up 3 17s and see what you get. 7, 14, 21, 22, 23, 24.
Hey, it sure is. Well, the book is wrong and you're right. Wait, let me get the...
Lady Larkin, what's the matter?
Nothing.
Dauntless, get a chair. Dauntless, get a... Thanks, anyway. Here, Larkin. Come, sit down. Tell me, what's the matter? What happened?
The minstrel and I were going to run away together.
That's not so bad.
But we were caught.
That's not so bad.
They jumped off.
That's bad.
Mama can't do that.
Oh, yes, Mama can, Dauntless. Oh, well, please, Larkin, don't cry. Here, have a nice glass of water.
I'll drown myself.
You'll see. Fred will think of something. She's smarter than the arithmetic book.
That's it. Larkin, your worries are over.
What do you mean?
Well, tomorrow there's going to be a royal wedding. Dauntless and me. And whenever there's a royal wedding, well, there's a general amnesty. And all the prisoners are set free.
Is that true?
If Fred says it's true... It's true.
But are you positive you can pass the test? I mean, none of the others could.
Sure. Your minstrel will be out of jail in no time.
Oh, dear princess. I don't know how to thank you. If it's a girl, we're going to name her Fred.
Boy, you are wonderful.
Really?
Really. Where are you going?
You know, Dauntless, the way I feel right now, if your mama asked me to name every star in the sky, I bet you I could do it.
Oh, she won't give you that, but she might give you spelling.
Oh, well, that's my very best subject.
Spell kiss.
Kiss. K-Y-S-S-E. Kiss.
Spell, knight.
Knight? You mean like a knight in shining armor? Or like... The NYT is balmy as it can be. And I can see my L-U-K-Y.
Your class.
Give a person a test.
And that person will pass.
When a person's in LUV, with a person like YUE.
YUE?
YEU?
YEU?
YEUEU?
Y.
Oh.
Oh.
YO?
Oh.
The daring is to can be done.
And the perfectest prize can be won.
You're a lyrical oracle.
That's cause I'm under a phantasmagorical.
Spell it.
It, I-T, it.
No, the other word. It's getting late.
You better go.
I better go.
Good night.
Fred?
Hmm?
I'm sure you'll pass Mama's test tomorrow. I'm pretty sure. If you don't, I'll understand.
The history of Prince Valdair. And so, young Prince Valdair, after having slain the dragon Fafnir, rescued the princess Grigga, and together they mounted his horse Trigga. And rode off to the castle Wunderbar, where they were married and lived happily ever after with the blessings of her fairy godmother. That girl had outside help. I haven't got a fairy godmother. I haven't even got a godmother. All I have is Dauntless. Dauntless. Oh, they tell us that falling in love is enthralling. I knew it the moment it happened.
Kingdom unless I attend to the details myself. Are they nice and dainty?
Like
whipped cream, Your Majesty.
And the pea, is it small enough?
Infinitesimal.
Quiet! This is the most princess-proof test you've thought of yet. And you know what I like about this special.
Mr. Littlegate to be killed after all.
Oh, yes, he is. The Queen said...
Oh, but you don't understand. There's going to be a general amnesty. And, oh, Your Majesty, Princess Winifred is going to pass the test and everything...
Who told you so?
Princess Winifred,
they all say that and they all fail.
Oh, but she must pass the test or else I...
Oh, look at it this way, m'lady. We all have to go sometime. Besides, you look beautiful in black. She really loves him. I have to help her. If only we knew what the test was. You know? Tell me! Horsemen. Night. Two. Tonight. The test is tonight. The whole thing. Bed. Somebody under the bed. Something under the bed. What is it? Peekaboo? 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 A pea under the mattress. If she sleeps, she's out. Thank you, Your Majesty. No, no, you can't come with me. It's too dangerous.
What's the matter, Papa?
Besides, if your son is getting married tomorrow, you should have that talk with him right now. Dauntless, your father wants to have a little... man to man.
What is it, Papa? What do you want to talk about? Well, Papa. Stop. Look. Listen. Oh, stop, look, listen. Man. Little man.
I see, but tell me, Father, please, oh, tell me how.
Bee on boy flower. Boy flower dust gets on bee. Bee flies the girl flower. Dust touches girl flower seed. Oh, I see.
No, I don't see. But still not clear to me.
Kerry. Sounds like Kerry. Perry. Terry. Oh, Mary. Man and woman get married. Winifred and White. Love each other. Laughter. After.
And after that, it's very
after that. What happens? What happens? Oh, Father, tell me, please. Shall I go and pick some flowers? Shall I go and catch some bees?
Princess Winifred and I will get married. And after that, and after that, and after that,
Stork. The stork will come and bring us a baby?
Oh, Papa, I know all about the stork. Mama told me about that years ago.
Wait a minute, Papa.
Flower, seed, man, woman, bee, baby, small. It isn't the stork. It isn't the stork. It isn't the stork at all. The life is grand.
Father, I love you so.
And now, in Winifred's bedchamber, the stage was set. 16. 17, 18,
19, 20 downy mattresses. And one little, small, tiny pea. And to lull her to sleep, the nightingale of Samarkand. Everything.
Yes, ma'am.
And the girl, where is whatchamacallit? Doesn't she know it's long past bedtime? Why, I should think she would be simply dropping with exhaustion. Oh, there you are, ready for bed. You must be sure and get a good night's sleep tonight so you'll be fresh early tomorrow morning for your trip back to your kingdom or wherever you're going. The hypnotic mirror. Yes. Well, where is the incantation? The wizard said it would be written right on the wrapper. Yes. Silken swishing sibilance wraps us in a gentle trance. Deep in Morpheus' arms we lie. Off we go to beddy by.
Hey, you know, I think I'm getting a sky right here.
Bring the sleeping draught. Yes. Drink a little extract of opium and warm milk before going to bed. Oh. Ah, now, I'm sure we're going to get a good night's sleep. I wish I could say the same for myself. And to be absolutely sure you have no trouble drifting off, I've prepared a special treat. Sing, birdie. This castle is going to get a good night's sleep.
All right, sheep. I'm ready whenever you are. One, two, three, four, five, six.
Fix it myself, Mama.
Well, now, why are you wearing that so early in the morning?
Oh, today's the day of the test, Mama. Oh. I want to look my best for Princess Winifred.
Why, dauntless, the test is all over, dear.
What? Oh, when was it?
Last night. We put her to bed on 20 downy mattresses with a pea under the bottom one to test her sensitivity. And of course the pea would have kept a true princess awake.
And she slept.
Well, good heavens, dear. She was practically falling asleep before she even got into bed. And yawning like a vulgar scullery maid. I mean, she looked ghastly, darling, and old enough to be your... Good morning, everyone. See the princess on her way. Well, since she is such a great favorite of ours, I have decided that she shall receive an extra special consolation prize. With us?
Here, Your Majesty, a very thoughtful gift.
Charming, charming. Oh! Yes. Well, now where is our little slugabed? She should be getting an early start.
37,428.
She isn't even dressed yet. She must have slept like a baby.
37,429 what?
Sheep!
Hey, what do you stuff your mattresses with anyway? Jousting equipment?
What do you mean?
I mean that bed ought to be moved down to the torture chamber. You mean you didn't sleep? I never shut my eyes.
You passed!
Oh,
the test! Mama put a pea under 20 mattresses and you fell in, and now we can be married!
Oh,
my beloved!
A pea? Under 20 mattresses? Well, no wonder I'm black and blue. 20 mattresses, huh? Dauntless, dear, I think I'll leave the wedding arrangements up to you. Oh, and while you're at it, why don't you shop around for a small kingdom for us somewhere? I have a feeling we're not going to want to live with the in-laws.
Oh, she's going to get cold sleeping on that bare table. I better take her up to her room.
Mother, wait! Well,
what should I wait for, Mama?
Oh, to give this matter proper consideration.
Well, she passed the test, and I have to take her up to our room.
I said wait. Now, you listen to your mother. Throughout this heartbreaking business, I have never nagged, never interfered, and never expected one solitary word.
Mama, quiet. She's asleep.
But I will not allow you to throw yourself away on this.
Shh.
Nobody.
Mama, quiet.
I mean, look at her. Oh, she may have passed the test, but I must say, I've never trusted anyone with those shifty little eyes and that mean little mouth.
I told you to stop. Shut up!
Look, Trump.
The mouse has devoured the hawk. The queen can't talk.
I
what?
I can.
And I've got a lot to say.
Well, good night, everybody. Unhand the boy. Go ahead, Dauntless. Now you asked for it, Agravaine. And you got it. From now on, when I say hop, I want you to hop. Hop! Jump! Jump!
I'd better get that pea out of the bed.
How did she stay awake? That pea was awfully small.
But it wasn't the pea, it wasn't the pea, it wasn't the pea at all.
Oh, life is grand. It's very interesting. We think we understand.
Delicate and dainty as a bride.
Mattress was written for television by Marshall Bearer, Jay Thompson, and Dean Fuller. Adler, vinyl flooring from Antico. This program was pre-recorded.